So what is judiciary? What is judiciary?
Checks and balances.
Checks and balances? For enforcing the laws. Judiciary enforces the laws. Protect the rights of the people. Protecting the rights of the people. It is also the protector of the constitution. Deals with various civil and criminal cases. So, judiciary comprises of judges. They form various benches to give
judgments.
Through judgments, various benches. So various benches, they will give judgments. Indian judiciary is called unified and integrated judiciary system. So if we go to the history of judiciary in the from ancient to till now, ancient India judiciary is trial and error. It is based or linked to religion. Ancient India, it is linked to religion. Religion and dharma. What is dharma? The duties to be carried out by every single individual to establish righteousness in the society. What are the four dharmas? We have already discussed in art and culture. Dharma, ardha, kama, moksha. So there are duties of the individuals. If they fail to do any duty, they are
punished.
Trial by the they are punished. Medieval, when it comes to medieval, the doctrine of judiciary is king can do no wrong. King can do no wrong. King can do no wrong. What does it mean?
King judgment should be.
Yes. He can do anything. He can punish everyone. This is somewhat arrogant. Arrogatory. After this, British system came. British Anglo-Saxon jurisprudence. With British, India introduced with Anglo-Saxon jurisprudence. Right. The formal courts established by during 1765 to 1773. Warren Hastings established two court system, Mufsil, Diwani Adalat, Mufsil, Nizamat Adalat or Fauzdari Adalat. Warren Hastings. These are lower courts. What is the meaning of Mufsil? Mufsil. Remote or rural. Remote or rural. I will come to. Just wait. Warren Hastings, Mufsil, Fauzdari Adalat for civil criminal cases. Mufsil Diwani. Diwani means civil cases. He also established appellate courts. Appellate courts are district courts, not district courts. there is a term called sadar. Sadar, the term terminology is still used in North India. The terminology, majority of the terminology in North India, Odisha, they follow this convention. They follow the district headquarters as sadar. We don't follow that. Sadar means urban or district. Sadar Nizamat Adalat. These are appellate courts. Judgments from these courts can be appealed to Sadar Nizamat Adalat. Nizamat means criminal. Sadar Diwani Adalat. Civil. Now, 1773 Act established
Supreme Court
at Calcutta. Supreme Court of Fort Williams. Supreme Court at Calcutta. One Chief Justice and
three judges.
One CJ and three judges. Later, Cornwallis came. He abolished all this, he established district courts. This is the history of Indian judiciary. Later various through acts, 1919 Act, 1920, 1935 Act established Federal Court of India. Later after independence, Supreme Court of India has been established. Now we will see the hierarchy of various courts in India. I told you in the earlier of this class, India follows unified and integrated system. There is no division of judicial powers like administrative and executive and what are the powers? Legislative powers. It is unified and integrated. So you know that what is civil and what is criminal?
Yes, sir.
Civil and civil relates to rights of the person in the matters of property, marriage, divorce. Top of the court is
Supreme Court.
The constitutional provisions are? You finished? Article 124 to 147. Below which?
High Court.
Constitutional provisions are 214 to? No idea. 231. Now, here below which we have district courts. These are all called subordinate courts. District courts and metropolitan courts. Metropolitan and urban areas. Mobile courts come under special courts.
Special mobile courts.
District courts. Again, district courts, we have classification of civil and
criminal.
So the JM District Judge Act has both civil and criminal. When it comes to civil, he is called as District Judge or Civil Judge. District Judge or Civil Judge. Below the judge, below which?
Additional.
First class civil judge or senior civil judge. At the lower level, junior civil judge, court of junior civil judge or subordinate courts. What are the provisions of subordinate courts? Article 233 to 236. criminal side, the same civil judge, he acts as the sessions judge. That court is called sessions court. Below which chief magistratial judge, chief magistrial judge, magistrial judge or this is also called municipal courts. Junior civil judge had the municipal courts. Chief magistrial judge or magistrial judge? Chief magistrial judge. District judge acts as a both civil and criminal. When he acts as the civil, when he trials civil cases, he is called as the district judge. When he trials the criminal cases, he is called as the sessions judge. Sessions. Metropolitan courts. Here again civil and criminal. Here chief metropolitan judge. City civil court, this is called as city civil court. City civil court and sessions court again. Again senior metropolitan judge. Metropolitan judge. Again criminal sessions court. Chief metropolitan judge. Again same chief magistral judge or chief magistral judge for metropolitan. Chief magistral judge for metropolitan. Below which metropolitan judge, chief magistral judge for metropolitan. This is for urban areas. And the another courts are special courts and here we have tribunals, fast track courts, and the third category is family courts, fourth category. Exclusively deals with civil cases in the matters of marriages and divorce. I am just giving only hierarchy. The other provisions, independence, appointment of judges, their powers, their jurisdiction, you will study in judiciary. I am here to discuss only hierarchy and various civil and criminal laws and criminal codes. So I told you this, the Indian judiciary is protector of the Indian constitution and rights of the people, and to check the validity of a law adopted by or enacted by parliament or state assemblies. Both Supreme Court and High Court have the powers to check the validity of any law under Article 32 and
34.
Article 32 and Article 32 for Supreme Court and Article 35, 226 for High Courts. Both have the judicial review powers. They can check the whether it is a valid law or not. Article. Article 32 judicial review for Supreme Court and Article 226 for High Courts. Which has the wider powers of judicial review, High Court or Supreme Court? Supreme Court. So judicial review under Article Judicial review under Article 32 for Supreme Court, Article 226 as for High Courts. So, in checking the validity of the laws, the judiciary follows three principles, three doctrines. Doctrine of pith and substance. Doctrine of pith and substance, doctrine of severability, and third, doctrine of colorable legislation. Any idea of pith and substance? You might have been told. Federal provisions for you completed? Federal system not completed. So, according to the doctrine of pith and substances, the courts will check whether the law is taking away any federal provisions or not. We'll check the federal provisions. If that law is abrogating the federal provisions envisaged in the constitution, or one level of government encroaching the power of legislation into another level of government, the law can be invalid. Suppose we have division of powers, right? Union list and state list. If parliament encroaches and make a legislate on a subject which is mentioned in the state list, and if it is complained in the judiciary, the Supreme Court or High Court can declare that law as invalid. Why? It is taking federal provisions. So according to the doctrine of pith and substances, if law is abrogating the federal provisions, the law can be invalid. Doctrine of severability. If the law is legislated by any parliament or assembly and it is taking away any of the constitutional provisions, or it is against any of the constitutional provisions, the law can be declared invalid, null and void. If the law is taking lies taking or abrogating the, use the word, these technical words while writing, abrogating the constitutional provisions, the law can be null and void. doctrine of colorable legislation, what can be directly legislated cannot be legislated indirectly. Always try to legislate direct provisions, direct legislation. Of the judiciary evolution have been taking place from 1952 till now, the concept of basic structure, right? You might have, what is basic structure? What is basic structure? Any idea? Huh? What is basic structure? Certain features of the constitution so important that cannot make any legislation disturbing those constitutional provisions. I will tell some important cases in the evolution of basic structure. So you know that part 3 of the constitution, fundamental rights, article 12 to 35, fundamental rights, article part 4, DPSP, article 36 to 51, DPSP, right. You have some of the important cases you had previously, right to property was there. Now it was made just mere legal right under article 300A. Because right property was the bone of contention between various parties. Right? Previously, many parties moving to courts and disturbing legislative provisions also. So in 1935, first case came whether fundamental rights can be amended or not. Amendability, you know the amendment, how the constitution can be amended? Article, under article 368. So since, what is the reason behind making this provision, article 368? To make the constitution living document. It cannot be, the provision should not be rigid. It should providing a way for making the amendments according to the time and need and circumstances. So under article 368, constitution can be amended with simple majority to make constitution a living document. So the constitution can be amended from the time and need, according to the time and need. Simple majority, another is special majority. And third provision is special majority with ratification from half of the states.
State ratification.
Special majority plus ratification by at least half of the states. Recently it passed this provision, keeping in view of this provision. What was the recent act that passed?
NJIC.
No.
NJIC
was struck down by the Supreme Court in 2051. Now there is no need for discussing about that. So recent act was passed was GST. 101 Constitutional Amendment Act. Economic weaker section, it is not abrogating any federal provisions.
Recent amendment.
No, I said recent amendment, specific special majority with ratification of half of the states. So according to those provisions, what was the recent act passed was 101 Constitutional Amendment Act. GST. Other provisions that can be changed by this is election of presidents, because this is involving the federal provisions, changing the federal provisions. Here GST, financial relations and taxation powers between the center and states have been affected because states lost some of their taxation powers, indirect taxation powers. So the first question come in Sankari Prasad versus Union of India 1951. Sankari Prasad versus Union of India 1951. In this question, the first question came whether fundamental rights can be amended or not. The Supreme Court said Parliament can take away any of the provisions of the Constitution. It said fundamental rights can be amended. FRs can be amended by the Parliament. Doctrine of basic structure are some of the provisions are so important that Parliament cannot take away or abrogate the spirit of those provisions, like Republican form of government, secular provisions, right? Doctrine of judicial review. It has been evolving from time to time, adding some of the provisions to the judicial basic structure. Now second case, in first case it said fundamental rights can be amended. Second case, Sajjan Singh versus State of Rajasthan 1960. State of Rajasthan, it was reiterated 1960, again it said same thing. The same had been reiterated here. Reiterated by the Supreme Court. Means again it said fundamental rights can be amended. Sajjan Singh versus State of Rajasthan 1960. Now you might have studied important case 1967 Golaknath case. There they reversed the original judgment. Golaknath versus Union of India 1967, Supreme Court reversed the earlier judgment. Reversed earlier judgment. What she said in the earlier judgment? Fundamental rights can be amended. Now it's here it said fundamental rights cannot be amended because they were so sacrosanct that they cannot be amended. They cannot be amended and they cannot be, because it said they are so sacrosanct and immutable. Cannot be amended because Supreme Court considered them as sacrosanct and immutable. Now Parliament reacted. Why shouldn't I amend? It reacted with 24th Constitutional Amendment 1971. To counter Golaknath case, Parliament came up with 24th Constitutional Amendment Act 1971, which amended. Parliament has the absolute power to amend any part of the Constitution. Parliament can amend any provision of the Constitution, any provisions, including FRs. parliament can amend any provision including fundamental rights. Now again Supreme Court reacted with in one important case, very important case. It is the biggest Supreme Court constitutional bench formed so far with how many judges. It is biggest nine member judge bench for constitutional bench. So far it is the biggest. On 24th April 1973, it reacted, it countered with Kesava Nanda Bharati case. Now Supreme Court came up with Kesava Nanda Bharati case. It is a turning point in the Indian judiciary. It is the one of the Kesava Nanda Bharati versus, is it State of Kerala or Union of India? State of Kerala. I think it is day 24, not important, but I am saying for your idea. The biggest constitutional bench formed so far. So for nine judges. Yes, what it said? Basic structure. Yes, what it said? Yes, Parliament has the power to amend any part of the Constitution, including FR, but it cannot disturb basic structure. So it came up with basic structure. It reiterated Parliament power to amend any provision, any provisions of the Constitution of India, including FRs, but should not disturb basic structure. Now in 75, one important case that led to emergency. What is that case? Indira Gandhi versus Rajanarayana. Indira Gandhi versus Rajanarayana, 1975. Again it reiterated the concept of basic structure. Indira Gandhi versus Rajanarayana, 1975, reiterated basic structure. And one more important case in 1980. What is that case? 1980. Minerva Mills case, 1980. Minerva Mill case, 1980. What happened? Rajanarayana, there is a discussion about Rajanarayana. Minerva Mill case, 1980. Again, it added. It said both FRs and DPSP are important. Both forms, there should be a balance between fundamental rights and directive principles of state policy. So if some of the laws which give effect to the DPSP under 39C, the law cannot be invalidated on the grounds of it is violating the Article 14 and Article 19. it try to maintain a balance between FRs and DPSP. Fundamental rights and DPSP, both form the bedrock of the constitution. Both are important. Previously, they used to give priority to fundamental rights rather than DPSP. Now, if the law, because DPSP promote which state? Welfare state. Welfare state. Tomorrow I will take some labor laws and all. I will tell in that concept of socio-economic development of the people. This is fundamental rights.
Individual.
This give political democracy. Political democracy. So now, in the keeping in view of the growing Indian population and appalling poverty, it is we also need to have importance to give directive principles of state policy. That is why it said there should be a balance between fundamental rights and directive principles of state policy. Now another important case in 1990, Kito Alon case. Kito Alon versus Jachilu. Kito Alon. ...1993 case, it said free and fair elections are part of basic structure, free and fair elections. Free and fair elections are part of basic structure, and 1985, 91st Constitution Amendment Act added 10th schedule to Constitution. What is the 10th schedule regarding anti-defection? According to the anti-defection law, who has the power to take decision whether defection is correct or not? Speaker has the final authority to. In this said, speaker decision can be reviewed, can be judicially reviewed. Whether it is his decision is on malafide grounds or not, speaker decision can be reviewed. Free and fair elections have been added to the basic structure. What are the constitutional article for elections? 324 to 329. Oh, you remember 329A also? Somebody said 329A. Speaker decisions can be reviewed here. Next important case is SR Bommai. SR Bommai case 1994. It added secularism to the basic structure. Here, SR Bommai case, it said the legitimacy of the government has to be established on the floor. Floor test. I think you might be following recent Maharashtra case. Floor test should be conducted immediately. The legitimacy of the government has to be established on the floor. So, governor cannot arbitrarily invite someone to form government. Now, So these are all important cases. If any is some important case, we will discuss in some other class. And now we will discuss civil and criminal cases. You know the so far we discussed the judicial review powers of Supreme Court and High Court. They are the protector of constitution and rights of the individuals. So you can read what are all the provisions of Supreme Court under 124 to 147. I will not discuss now because I am here to take only hierarchy of criminal and civil laws today. And High Court 2114 to 231, subordinate courts 233 to 236. Now we will see various civil and criminal laws in India. Civil laws related to property, inheritance, contracts, business, marriage and divorce, marriage and divorce. So 1835 to codify all the laws. 1835, I am talking about 1835, Macaulay Law Commission was formed in 1835 to codify all civil and criminal laws in India. So to trial civil cases, we have Civil Procedure Code. Before that, I will two principles I have to tell: doctrine of substantive laws and doctrine of procedure laws. We make the note of doctrine of substantive laws and doctrine of substantive laws. Doctrine of substantive laws. The laws tells us the rights of the individual persons and legal relationship between the people and state. Rights of the individual. Rights of the individual. Individuals are people. Means all laws, all legislations, and legal relations between the people and state. Example. No, I am talking about laws. Any laws that gives power rights to the individuals, and legal relations between the people and state, it says it is right or not. What is that law? Freedom. No, there is a law, codified law is there from 1835 onwards. He codified all the laws. This shows the legal relations, whether the act committed by a person is correct or not. According to the provisions of which provisions we can decide the act is right or not, or he has the property right or not. IPC is Indian Penal Code 1860. IPC, CPC also. IPC 1860 is the substantive law. substantive law, it relates the legal relations between the people and or any other laws made by the parliament or state assembly in civil matters. In criminal matters, IPC 1860 says various provisions, various sections which says whether it is right or not. Evidence Act 1872. I am just giving example. Any other laws are substantive laws which provides rights on the individual. Now, doctrine of procedural laws or procedural laws. Here, procedural laws are the laws which tells the procedures to be followed by the various organizations like judiciary and police to implement substantive laws. Procedures to be followed by various organizations like judiciary and police to implement substantive laws. These procedures are CRPC, Criminal Procedure Code, Civil Procedure Code. These tells how a case can be filed, how a trial can be done, how an investigation can be done. Now we will go to civil and criminal laws in India. So as I told you, civil laws about the individual rights. Now for civil procedure is, what is civil procedure? What is civil procedure code? I tell procedure. What is the procedure? How will you go to a court? How will you file a suit? How will you file a suit? Civil procedure. Now you are done with, no? You are understanding doctrine of substantive laws, substantial laws and procedural laws. Now civil and criminal laws in India, we will see civil procedure code. CPC. It tells about the various procedures to be followed by the individual and courts. Various procedures means, what are the various procedures? Opening a suit, procedures to pass orders, procedures to pass orders by the court, court fees, stamps, jurisdiction of the courts, whether this can encroach on the another jurisdiction of the court or not. Jury, what is jurisdiction? Territorial extent of the court. Jurisdiction of the court. Evidence, matters of appeals, all these procedures are discussed under civil procedure code. What is the first civil procedure code in India? CPC, British time, 1859. Civil procedure is 1859. Both came maybe 1 or 2 years. I told 1860 18. So CPC, then make a correction. I'm sorry, civil procedure 1859. History I said. Now it is amended in Civil Procedure Code 1908, still we are following that. CPC 1908. CPC 1908, we have 158 sections. 158 sections and one schedule. This is the order and decree. So we have 158 sections and one schedule.
Schedule 9.
Schedule in CPC 1908, not schedule 9 and 10.
One schedule.
So according to CPC, courts can, I'll discuss only the three important powers of the courts. Courts can issue decrees, judgments, and orders. According to CPC 1908, courts can issue decrees, judgment, orders for civil matters. Decrees, orders, and judgments for civil matters. Section 2. Section 2 and subsection 2 of the CPC, courts can issue decrees. Decree says rights of the all parties. Decree recognize the rights of the all parties involved in the suit. It is a formal expression for recognizing the rights of the all parties involved in the suit. Suit meant filing a case. Section 2 and subsection 9 can give judgment. This is a formal statement given by the judge for decree. Formal statement given by the, at the last day of the judgment gives one formal statement. Formal statement given by the judge. Formal statement given by the judge for passing decree. So if decree, there is no need for giving judgment. For judgment, judge has to give formal statement. Decree, there is no need for formal statement, or he can give or he may not give. But for judgment, judge should give formal statement. Section 33 of the CPC gives order. Order means final. It is final. Final adjudication between the parties. Section 33 of the CPC. Order. Order is the final statement by the judge for adjudicating, final adjudicating. What is adjudication? What is adjudication? Complete settlement. section 33 CPC. Now this is the only civil important order, decree and judgment. Now we will move to criminal. What are criminal laws? Civil laws, I told you, this property, inheritance, marriage, divorce and all.
Murders.
Which disturb the law and established law and order. Criminal cases are murders, thefts, rapes, violence, attacks. All these are criminal cases. For adjudicating, for procedure we follow is CRPC. Criminal cases are dealt with IPC, IPC 1860. What are the various laws we have? CRPC 1860, 1861, and then Evidence Act 1872. One more act is Negotiable Instruments Act 1881. According to all these laws, we will follow procedure in criminal procedure. This is for criminal. So what is the procedure for a criminal? Criminal cases. Suits are only for civils. Criminal cases?
Tribunals.
Criminals, right. Criminals. We follow the, we'll complaint in the police station. Police station file. FIR. FIR tell to, then investigation. Investigation then trial. Now we will see the various sections of criminal. So IPC contains 484 sections. CRPC 1861 contains 484 sections and two schedules. So the orders, decrees and judgments only related to civil cases. Mainly order and decrees. Judgments are also there in criminal cases. Order and decrees we see in civil cases. Shall we continue criminal or we are feeling bored of lot of sections? Right? So criminal cases prosecuted through government, and prosecuted through private parties also, private complaints or private parties. So government, we have section 225 of CRPC. CRPC is procedures followed by dealing with the criminal cases. Section 225 of CRPC, government, these are investigated and prosecuted by Directorate of Prosecution. Section 225 of CRPC,
Criminal cases under government are prosecuted by the Directorate of Prosecution. Now who will deal with this? Public prosecutor. Based on the FIR report, based on the FIR, public prosecutor deals with criminal cases under government or Directorate of Public Prosecution. Private parties, complaint can be given by the or criminal cases are moved by the private parties through private lawyers. This is through private lawyers. It is under Section 138 of Negotiable Instruments Act 1881. Any confusion here? So once FIR is registered, the cases are prosecuted in the court by public prosecutor. That is through government. The FIR, police will, after registering FIR, they will be prosecuted in the court by the public prosecutor. In the private complaints, private lawyers under Section 138, under 138 of Negotiable Instrument Act. 138 of Negotiable Instruments Act of 1881. So when we say about criminal cases, what is the terms we come across? Say loudly. Bailable, non-bailable, warrant,
summons,
cognizable, non-cognizable cases, various criminal cases. Now we'll see. What is cognizable cases?
Sir, in criminal courts, how government in the criminal courts?
Criminal?
Government
or the interface to criminal court. Government that will come under civil cases.
No, sir, the criminal under government.
This is government. Through government. Through government means public prosecutor. Police will send that case to. After arresting the accused, police will send the accused to the case, and they are prosecuted by the public prosecutor. The accused can have a defense lawyer. Accused can have a defense lawyer under Section 51A of CRPC. I will discuss. This is under public prosecutor. Directorate of Public Prosecutor is under work under the government. Now I am telling private complaints. This is not registered to the police. Private complaints are private lawyers. The case is not registered in the police station, not through the FIR. This is not through the FIR. Private parties can directly go to the private lawyer and they can file a complaint or can have prosecution. This is related to the all FIRs registered under the police station. First information report. So warrant cases. Warrant cases are the cases of which can have death penalty, life imprisonment, or imprisonment greater than 3 years. Death penalty cases, life imprisonment, or imprisonment greater than 3 years. Another is summon cases. Imprisonment less than 3 years. Cognizable offenses or cognizable cases. Cognizable offenses are which are mentioned under Schedule 1 of the CRPC. Court warrant is not required. Police can directly arrest. Cognizable offenses which have imprisonment greater than 2 years. Police can directly arrest without warrant. Police can arrest the accused without warrant. Without a warrant, cognizable. Based on the recent increase of incidents like rapes and assault on the women, CRPC amendments 2013 came. There even small events also we will discuss that they made cognizable offenses. All attacks on the women made cognizable offenses in CRPC Amendment Act 2013. I am going to discuss a little later. Police can arrest without warrant. Non-cognizable offenses. Again, it is discussed under which attracts the life imprisonment less than 2 years. Police need warrant to arrest the accused. Warrant from a magistrate or court. Magistrate at court is needed for arresting the accused. Another cases are bailable and non-bailable. Bailable cases also which are serious offenses which are in serious nature which attracts death penalty or life imprisonment or imprisonment greater than 3 years. Bailable cases. Bailable cases which attracts imprisonment greater than 3 years, death penalty or life imprisonment or imprisonment greater than 3 years. So bail cannot be given. What is a bail? What is a bail?
Court gives a time period for him to prove himself.
You will see in lot of movies, right?
To prove himself, sir.
What is a bail?
To prove himself.
Since it is a bail, it is a security and undertaking given by the accused through a lawyer, right? He should follow some undertaking which is mentioned on the bail. Security and undertaking. Next is non-bailable cases. Sorry, it is less than 3 years. See, babe, I am sorry. This is non-bailable cases which attracts death penalty, life imprisonment or imprisonment greater than 3 years, bail cannot be given. Bailable cases which attracts less than 3 years of imprisonment. Less than 3 years of imprisonment. See, why I am saying these basics? Because while you current affairs, while you read current affairs and recent political issues or recent amendments to laws, you will read all this. By this time, you might have read about the CRPC because of the Hyderabad incident. You might have come across various laws about criminal procedure and IPC. Have you read articles? I think you will be flooded with a lot of articles in the next coming 10 days. And after 10 days, they will forget and again new incident will come. So bail can be given here through a lawyer. He can be discharged, he can be released from the police station, which attract less than 3 years of the imprisonment. Now, various stages of criminal cases. First is detention, prosecution and trial. Detention means, what is detention? What is detention means? Arrest. Detention means arrest and FIR. Here section 154 and 155 of CRPC. And prosecution. This is also called investigation. Detention, FIR, investigation stays. Next is prosecution stays. And next is trial. What is detention affair stage? A complaint will be filed. Complaint will be filed in the local police station. They will register FIR. According to the FIR, they will start investigation. Investigation and they gather evidence. Visit the place of the crime act. Visit the place and gather evidence. They also can have search. And arrest the accused. What is the article 22, 20, article 20 and subclass 2 and article 20 and subclass 3 of the Indian Constitution?
Right to remain silent.
Is it remain silent? What is article 20?
Protection of unlawful acts.
Arrests, right?
Arrests.
So according to the article, accused should be article according to the constitutional article and section 50 of the CRPC, the accused should be produced before a magistrate within 24 hours of the arrest. Within 24 hours, they will arrest accused, and within 24 of the arrest, they will be produced before the magistrate. So magistrate prosecutes based on the FIR report. He may discharge the accused, or he may send them to further detention, or send to the local court. Remand, 14 days remand. Magistrate can discharge or further remand. Further remand of 14 days, and they will be again produced before the prosecutor. And if prosecutor gather, prosecutor and police gather sufficient evidence between the period, they will be sent to the court. They will be sent to the court. See, till it is accused is proved guilty, he is presumed to be innocent. That is called doctrine of innocence. They follow doctrine of innocence. He is proved guilty, he is presumed to be innocent. So the courts here, the courts can take up the case and hear the and record the courts record the evidence, hear the accused, can have a lawyer. Who is that?
Private lawyer or government provided?
Defense lawyer. This is obviously criminal lawyer, because this, we are talking about criminal cases. 51A of CRPC, according to the 51 CRPC, criminal can have a, accused can have a defense lawyer. And finally, see, you should remember the doctrine of innocence. What is the doctrine of innocence? Till he presumed guilty in by any court, he is presumed to be innocent. Till proves the guilty, he is considered to be innocent. So Article 50A, we told, within Article 50, within 24 hours he should be presented before the magistrate. 51A, we have, he can have a lawyer. 53 and 53A, he should be produced for medical tests. Section 53 and 53A, he should be produced for medical tests. These are the sum of the rights of the accused.